This week on NBS 24/7, the aftermath of the Hmiel Jarrett confrontation.
Where do you think he's going? We're on a half-mile racetrack. He's got to use his head.
He threatened that he'd get me and all that stuff.
Why did they let a guy that's just been involved in an accident go down, walk up to a guy, and make threats to him on national TV?
David Stremme joins the Navy.
They're sending me to the confidence chamber later. What do you think of that?
And what do you do with a weekend off? These stories and more next. It's Monday morning in Mooresville, North Carolina. But it isn't business as usual. Because the Bristol race got rained out on Saturday, most of the Fitz Bradshaw team was in Tennessee taking care of some unfinished business.
Ready, green, green, green.
Things got ugly quickly for Tim Fedewa and the number 12 Hot Tamales Dodge.
We got caught up in one right there. Got a lot of damage to the rear. He's rolling.
He got caught up in a wreck in the first lap.
Wheels are straight.
Don't think you got any chassis, guys. Let's get in here and get that bumper off. Get us all out. It's going to be okay.
Back in Mooresville, the Fab Shop workers watched from the break room.
It's unbelievable.
It's all college minutes. A couple days' work. Take care of it.
All right, we got to go here. We got to go. Go, clear all the way out. You're clear all the way out.
For now, this carnage was treated as a mere flesh wound. With a little maintenance, Fedewa got back on the track and finished 25th.
Pit road is open.
If the leader's pit, we'll come. If the leader's pit, we'll come.
Teammate David Stremme in the 14 Navy Dodge started 12th and had made his way into the top five.
Second gear of 3,500. Second gear of 3,500.
My radio any better than it was, David?
Yeah.
But there was a problem. A questionable radio system.
Clear by one now.
I can't hear nothing.
Car 2. Car 2.
I guess David just got turned right up into him.
He got wrecked because he had to pick because the stupid radio was sticking. These dumb piece of radios we got still, we can't get them fixed. He didn't have a spotter.
Yeah, it probably did him in right there.
John, if we got back out, how many positions will we pick up?
Just a minute. Give me a minute here. I'm looking.
Guys, just get it where we can load it. Not good with me.
A 38th place finish went into the books for the 1480 Dodge.
So that's two of our cars completely gone out. Did anything happen to Sterling? I mean,
Fitz Bradshaw's Sterling Marlin in the number 40 Janet King Dodge was just fine. With 72 laps to go, he led the race.
Yeah, come on, Sterling.
Guys, I don't think it's going to be take very long for Kevin Harvick to try to find a place to be able to get by this 40 car tonight.
I don't care about running 13th or 14th, okay? If he starts dropping back, you come get tired. And there's a caution, you come get tired.
Sterling couldn't hold off Kevin Harvick.
Harvick's going to take the lead here.
He dropped back a few spots, but managed a top five finish for the Fitz Bradshaw team.
That's fifth, buddy. Fifth. Sorry about the tires, man.
Good job, guys. Hey, that's something to be proud of.
Well, it's a good point today for the 40 needed it.
Peace, huh? That's great. Good.
Shame the other two guys didn't have a little better luck than we did, so.
That's all right.
Yeah. One thing about this sport, there's always next week.
Shane Hmiel could concur with that sentiment. Bristol would become the most controversial race he's ever run. His day started badly in the number 32 Winfield Chevy.
Inside.
A punctured tire.
One more inside.
But even worse.
Are we on the front stretch or the back stretch?
Shane had a lot of ground to make up.
Shane Hmiel has bumped and run the last three cars he's passed, and you see he's gotten the back of Dale Jarrett there at least once. It's an effective technique, but it's not pretty.
Right now, Shane Mills in the 13th position, Dale Jarrett in the 90 in the 12th position.
Whoa, and
Dale
Jarrett,
Shane Hmiel get together on the front stretch.
And Dale Jarrett climbs out unhurt. He is walking up track.
He's got that look like he may have something he wants to say to somebody.
Jarrett pointed his finger, Shane flipped his middle one back.
Got me 5:46.
Where the f*** you think you were going? It'll cost you one day.
Well, you better hurry up, because he ain't got but about a year left.
Aside from the threat, you like that, isn't it?
Yeah, that was just a show.
This bull f***ing NASCAR left to walk over to my car.
Simple on that, he's with it all.
Hmiel finished 12th. Jarrett ended up 30th.
Where do you think he's going? We're on a half-mile racetrack. He's got to use his head.
Gee, another driver upset with Shane Beal's driving. That's amazing.
I don't care about for Dale Jarrett. I just hate it for the Winfield Chevrolet. I'm sorry Dale Jarrett's car got tore, but when they're wrecking in front of you and you're trying to move and then you run into somebody, you know, how you going to blame that on somebody? But he threatened that he'd get me and all that stuff, and he better hurry up. This ain't got much longer.
Coming up, Shane's saga continues.
You don't race all day and then with 5 laps to go, just give up.
Shane races hard. He's my man. I'll stay behind him no matter what.
And Stremme takes a chance.
They're sending me the confidence chamber later. What do you think of that?
Tuesday at Mooresville gave the teams an opportunity to recap and reset after a long weekend in Bristol.
All I know is I kept looking in the mirror in the spoiler. Damn
it. You have a rough weekend and you tear your junk all up. It's probably the best therapy just to come back, cut it off yourself. Maybe helps the healing process a little bit. I don't know.
You run good and you can't show finishes, you know. I'm going on vacation. I got leave to go somewhere. I'm going to kill somebody. I just get that mad.
Stremme and Randy Cox's common goal was to win races in the number 14 Navy Dodge. In January, they built upon their strong relationship when they toured the U.S. Navy Recruit Training Command in Great Lakes, Illinois. They wanted a taste of what it takes to be in the U.S. Navy.
To do a 500-yard swim, 42 push-ups, 50 sit-ups, 6 pull-ups, and we go to the gym and do a mile-and-a-half run. They're all timed evolutions. And the first thing is jumping in the pool and doing the screening test. So who's going to pass today?
Randy Cox was confident he had the stamina to pass the requirements to be a Navy SEAL.
That's a long way.
He wasn't even halfway through.
Once you touch his lower body to the ground, you're done there, NASCAR.
Hey, you got to give the guy an A for effort.
That's why I like him. He'll just keep digging.
For the Navy, leadership and teamwork is crucial. David Stremme had the opportunity to share with the recruits what it takes to have a successful race team.
It takes a very strong team effort. We all work together as a unit, and it's something that you cannot just do it as one person.
The recruits wanted to show Stremme they knew exactly what team spirit is all about.
There was a ton of guys, and they were all real motivated. I mean, they were always screaming and yelling and, you know, chanting different things.
Whose house is this?
Ah!
Whose house is this?
Ah!
Right there!
Ah!
Right there!
Ah!
Throughout their visit, the boys from Fitz Bradshaw got to watch,
step it out quickly,
learn,
that's a little harder than what it looks, right?
And experience some of the things every Navy recruit goes through during their basic training.
Oh, hell, this ain't that bad. I've slept in worse than this.
If this was a mooring line and it gets too tight, if this mooring line would part, it roughly moves about 700 feet per second. It sounds just like a 45 caliber or a 9mm gun going off. So if you're in the path of that line, it would cut your legs off in a second.
But there was one experience David Stremme seemed to have on his mind more than any other.
So none of you have gone through the confidence chamber?
Not yet.
They're sending me the confidence chamber later. What do you think of that? Here's the PCs and we'll be okay.
If you have any medical conditions that we need to be aware about, go see our EMT now.
Last year, when members of Fitz Bradshaw visited the training center, the confidence chamber was filled with tear gas.
Well, hell, that's like spraying brake cleaner right in your eyes.
I remember last year when I watched the Navy team go up there on the show,
And I thought, oh, my goodness, I don't know if I'd do that. Well, I went in there, and, I mean, it was crazy.
And now it was Randy and David's turn.
Let's see what you got, Strumming.
Damn eyes are welded shut.
With the hardest part behind them, the guys were able to observe the best part of training, graduation. After meeting some of the top brass, who also happened to be big NASCAR fans, Stremme knew there was a lot to live up to.
I know, that's where everybody's like, oh yeah, you get the cool job of driving the cars. You don't have all the pressure and having to go out and win. I mean, I'm not just to represent myself, I represent like thousands of people. I mean,
it was neat to see them build confidence and work together as a team, same way that we do on our race team here.
Coming up, Shane speaks out.
What happened last Monday happened last Monday, and I'm over it.
Stremme steps out.
This is what I need to go to the track in. Better win some races before I do that, huh?
And Tim Fedewa? It looked like business as usual at Braun Racing on Tuesday.
When's the next time this race car runs?
This race car is not going to run again, so we need to get this out.
But there was something else on everyone's mind.
But they have a seven-second delay. Why can't they take that off TV?
Man, ever since Dale Jr. shit out that S-word, man, they've had a seven-second delay. And I tell you what, Daryl, it doesn't seem to be working.
I sure, when I left the racetrack on Monday afternoon, I didn't know this was going to end up happening out of it.
The talk and headlines were about Shane's gesture to Dale Jarrett.
This NASCAR thing with the obscenities. I totally understand what NASCAR is doing, but it's still, it just, what's the middle finger? I mean, we know what it means.
Shane was not ready to make any statement yet, but his teammates had plenty to say.
It's not like Shane meant to do it. Like, why would Shane want to, like, risk his car and his position?
They can say whatever they want to say. He came down the track. Cars were stacking up in front of him. He come down, and Shane knocked him sideways, thrown him out.
During a red flag, why do they let a guy that's just been involved in an accident, supposed to be in the ambulance, go down, walk up to a guy, and make threats to him on national TV?
For Director of Media Relations Allison Marshall, the phones were ringing off the hook.
You know, the way that it came off on the broadcast, it came off very, very one-sided. You know, I'm telling you that I would love to get you a response today, just so you can kind of see where we're coming from.
On Wednesday, NASCAR dropped the hammer with a penalty of $10,000 and 25 points.
And if the fans aren't outraged by what's going on here, I don't understand. Slowly, you guys are going to get your access pulled back to the point where there is none, because we can't risk anything.
Thursday, Shane joined Justin Labonte in Dallas for an advanced media tour to promote the next race at Texas Motor Speedway.
Hi, I'm Shane Mill, driver of the Winfield Chevrolet, and you're listening to 92.5, the classic. What the hell?
But there was only one subject everyone wanted to talk about.
Shane Mill has bumped and run the last three cars he's passed. And you see he's gotten the back of Dale Jarrett there at least once.
You got into a little bit of trouble last Monday at the Bristol race.
What has the biggest impact on you for that deal?
I'm listening back to that. And you get pissed at all.
If you let that stuff get in your head and beat you up, then they win.
Shane had been silent on the subject all week, but now had the opportunity to say his piece.
Didn't Dale Earnhardt Sr. wave to Jeremy Mayfield in much the same way that you waved at Dale Jarrett the other day?
Yeah, I don't think that's the first time that's ever happened. But, you know, that stuff happens. You know, you don't race all day and then with five laps to go, just give up. I don't race to make friends, but I don't race to make enemies either. The announcers made it sound a lot worse than it really was, I think. What happened last Monday happened last Monday, and I'm over it, and I'm going to Martinsville to run the Winfield Chevrolet in the truck race on Saturday.
With a long day and a media blitz behind him, Shane headed back home to get ready for Martinsville.
Hope y'all had fun. I did.
Coming up, is it good to be a Busch driver?
Give Dave a round of applause, y'all.
In Race City, it's an off week for the Busch teams. The Braun shop is empty, with big plans for the weekend.
And I wanted to go camping, but we'll be at soccer games all weekend. I tried to put my motorcycle in the shop. I've got to start riding.
At Fitz Bradshaw, it is mostly empty.
I'm going home to be with my lovely wife. We're going to celebrate our 16th, I believe it's 16th anniversary this weekend.
Owner Armando Fitz is ready for a break.
And I'm going to Palm Beach. It's been a long run and stuff, and the last 2 weeks have been stressful.
But not everyone at Fitz Bradshaw has time off.
The parts we needed to put our race car together didn't arrive until today, so, you know, we get stuck here working basically so, you know, we can get caught back up.
Under the watch of fierce protectors, driver Tim Fedewa will spend time at home.
Yeah, it's nice just to be home. I mean, you know, the problem is we still got a lot going on at the race shop. You know, I keep wondering why I'm so darn tired, but, you know, we've been at it for 6 weeks now.
The new Mrs. Fedewa adds her special touch to their home.
How much money did you save?
$80. Don't you love it?
Yeah, it's nice.
What else can go?
What a deal.
I got a honeydew list for him.
I got to wash my truck, change the oil, clean my bike up, clean the house.
Isn't that so much better than what was there?
Say yes.
Tim's a few years older than I am, so his taste sometimes stays back in the 80s. It's hard to keep it updated. Doesn't that look nice?
Yeah.
David Stremme's weekend plans? Florida, with his girlfriend Whitney and her family. One stop, naturally, was a visit to the National Museum of Naval Aviation in Pensacola.
So how many planes they have here in, under the roof?
We got a, we'll stay between 100 to 120 aircraft.
Wow.
At the beginning of World War II, we converted the auto industry to building airplanes.
The Blue Angels exhibit reminded David of the wild ride he took with him earlier this year.
This makes me sick. Even though I didn't throw up, but... That's a wild ride. It's pretty neat to come to the Naval Museum here and look at all the history of the airplanes, how the whole Navy has developed. You look at some of the men and some of the planes they were flying. I mean, wow. I mean, they talk about us running like 200 miles an hour. That's nothing to fly in some of them airplanes.
Looks like David may have some competition.
Sorry, David, I may go home with him. It's nicer.
That's fine.
What we need in our Navy race car.
Put in my plane. I want to take your picture.
No way. Yes, way. I'll stand by one here.
Get in the plane and hide.
I don't want to get in one.
Come on.
It's a pain in the butt to get in them. This is what I need to go to the track in. Helicopter. Better win some races before I do that. Huh?
A vacation in Florida wouldn't be complete without some fun in the sun.
I'm done. I thought I was in Lake Michigan, as cold as it is. We got some Kingsford support of Stacy Compton's team. Well, that's no good.
Later in the evening.
Which one did you drive, Busch? You dropped the beer truck? The Navy car? Get up here. Get up here. Come here. Y'all give Dave a round of applause, y'all. Sit up there.
Surely he won't forget this serenade.
Dave has lost that loving feeling.
Coming up, a weekend off? No way. Yeah. Shane Hmiel spent his weekend off, well, racing.
I really enjoy racing. Me and Billy Blue formed such a good relationship last year. I enjoy driving the truck. He makes a whole lot of fun, so I can come here and relax and not have to worry about the points or nothing like that.
Shane's presence did not go unnoticed.
A lot better than seven cheers.
Whether they were for or against him, Shane was there to race.
Great.
Shane would race hard, but new eyes would be watching his every move.
I didn't hit me. I didn't hit him.
Good, you'll be all right.
Stop, fellas. Good stop. I'll do my best.
The number 15 Winfuel Chevy stayed in the front of the field all day, but ran into trouble in the final laps.
They have a broken rear sway bar on that truck. He says it feels like it's about 50 feet off the ground.
But even with a broken sway bar, he battled the number 15 Chevy to a sixth place finish. Even after the checker, he was still in the thick.
What an idiot.
What did happen?
It was quite a week for Shane Hmiel, who could now finally find time to lay low.
Green flag.
So what's ahead for our teams? In seven races, they have yet to win. Shane Hmiel is ninth in the point standings.
There's your white flag. Nobody can even come close.
David Stremme, 11th.
Clear all around. Go get him, buddy.
And Tim Fedewa, 18th.
We got caught up in one right there. Got a lot of damage to the rear.
There are 28 more races to go for Braun Racing at Fitz Bradshaw. So hold on to your seats as the season-long saga continues on the next NBS 24/7.
That's what I'm talking about right there. That's what I'm talking about on pit road.